Our desire is that Latter-day Saints gain a greater understanding of our Muslim brothers and sisters.
Elder David A. Bednar and Elder Gerrit W. Gong of the Quorum of the Twelve Apostles of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints shared similarities between Muslims and Latter-day Saints at a Brigham Young University conference in Provo, Utah, last October.
One hope this evening is to help our church members better understand our own faith and our Muslim brothers and sisters as we join with goodwill and mutual respect.
Muslims and Latter-day Saints differ, of course, in some core doctrines, but we have many similar beliefs, values, and lifestyles. Over the past several years, our church and several Muslim imams and scholars have worked together intensively to prepare a pamphlet that we are pleased to introduce this evening.
At a time when societies and religious believers want and need mutual understanding, this pamphlet signifies a conscientious effort to provide dignity and tolerance for Muslim and Latter-day Saint believers. We are sincerely seeking to understand one another in open, honest, and authentic ways. This includes recognizing similarities and differences. It also means trying to see beyond falsehoods, stereotypes, or generalities.
Muslims, like Latter-day Saints and other Christians, live in different countries and cultures. Muslims are not only in the Middle East. The vast majority of Muslims live outside of the Arab world.
As we meet with Muslim leaders across the world, we talk about defending religious freedom. People of faith need to stand together for tolerance and dignity of people of all religious beliefs.
Our faith, our church, feels very strongly about religious freedom, not just for ourselves, but for all. Like some Muslims in the U.S. or elsewhere in the world, members of our church have felt the effects of persecution and profiling, and we join with good people everywhere in condemning such actions.
Across the world, Latter-day Saint Charities works closely with Islamic relief organizations to assist the poor and alleviate suffering, a core value important in both our faiths. I'm grateful our church's global humanitarian relief extends to people in some 200 different countries and territories without regard to race, religion, or ethnicity. We're aware that on occasion, a few church members have made false and cruel comments about Muslims. We need not repeat such comments or the biased thoughts or feelings behind them, but we do want to respond to them directly.
Not only are disparaging, generalized statements inaccurate and wrong, they are also highly offensive. Such biases cause those who feel that way to overlook the kindness and goodness of the overwhelming majority of all Muslims. Every major religion has extremists who misinterpret the teachings of their own religion or who seek to do wrong in the name of religion.
Let's use the pamphlet to illustrate some of those similar beliefs, values, and lifestyles to help Latter-day Saints better understand Islam.
When the waves of opposition to religious freedom sweep across this or any other nation, or when prejudice and hatred toward any people threaten either of us, we desire to join with you to ensure that our collective right to worship and to seek peace and prosperity persists. Elder Gong and I humbly pray the God of us all will watch over and bless each of us in this important and essential endeavor.